Well, hello there, amazing and wonderful nerdy people of YouTube. So I am on my Linux, not machine, but my Linux install, and I just got a Logitech mouse, and I want to see if I can configure it under Linux. And there is a small little program called Piper here that you can install, and I will have a link to this launchpad down below for Ubuntu. I don't know, with arts and stuff like that, if you look at it here, you can build it via the Mason build system. I think it's in the AUR. You may have to, you know, look at I was about to say the man pages. You have to investigate that for the specific system that you have. So if you are on Solus or Gentoo and stuff like that, it may not be in the repositories, it may be. But what Piper basically does is it handles your mouse. And as far as I know, it's only Logitech's font name from Light Redbeak Readme. Apparently, it should work with mouses, but I have only tried this with a Logitech mouse, so I can't really say if it works with Razer or anything like that. So you have to try that out yourself. But again, like I said, it's called Piper, and I will have the Ubuntu launchpad page down below. I will have the GitHub page down below, so you can either install it from source, or if you are on a Ubuntu-based system, you can then install it that way. It's a little bit cumbersome, but I hope this will help out. Why do I need this? Well, I like to use my mouse a lot. And this is basically what it gives you. You can have some profiles over here. You have the resolutions. And resolutions is like the sensitivity, report rate, or pull rate, or how you would call it, the DPI. You can see here it can go up to like a crazy amount of DPI. On Windows, you can customize the DPIs. Basically, you can put in any number of DPI you want. On Linux, you can't. Buttons. Basically, this is what they are doing. And you just click on it here, and then you find the button that you want it to do. So if I want the forward to be send keystroke, so I want to capture it. I want it, let's say I'm an MMO player. I want it to be number one. Apply. 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 Oh, something went wrong. The device have been reset to previous state. Again, it's not 100% working. It's still kind of somewhat in beta alpha, but it should work. We could actually try it out. So if you go into like a editor here, so let's do text editor. Which one was it? It was this one here. Yeah, it don't work. Let's try the backwards one here, and then do, let's do keystroke again. Let's do D. Maybe it was because I clicked it too much. Oh, I have to click apply. There you go. And it just bugged out a little bit because it did a pull rate. So I think it's because I have double stroke here. Yeah, see, now it's working. So I'm pressing my mouse right now. So I think this is because, oh, let's do that one there. I think it was because I was clicking it too much. There you go. One time. Apply. And you can see I'm moving my mouse now. So it's lagging a little bit because it's sending, it's updating the mouse and sending, or communicating with the mouse. So oh, now it's working. I'm clicking this button here right now. This button here. And now I'm clicking the other one. So it's not as smooth as under Windows. It's not as fancy under Windows. If you go into the LEDs here, you don't have the same options under Windows. Under Windows, you can get it basically register sounds on your system, and then it gives you basically like a representation of the sound. So if people are speaking or I'm hearing music, it pulsates in tune with the music, and I kind of like that for that little logo down here where space is just a G. I really, really like that. So it's not up to par with Windows, but it's way serviceable. Like I could definitely live with this with no problem whatsoever. So the cycle here, you can customize this, the breathing, you can turn it off. I could see myself live with that. You can see here about pipe, so it's a version 0.5. I could work with this. I could live with this. Am I a little bit sad that I don't get the same features as I do on the Windows? Yeah, a little bit. A little bit, but let's be honest. This is more than you need. Like, unless you are a competitive gamer and you are gaming left, right, and center and going to tournaments and stuff like that, this is way good enough. If you are a gamer or anything like that, this software will do you just good. Again, it has some problems. It could be better and stuff like that. Everything can be better. And I'm sure that when this gets updated, it will be an amazing program. I found this online and I wouldn't test it out until I got a new mouse. I got a new mouse. Thanks to YouTube, by the way. So I was like, let's boot into PopOS and test it. And again, it's a little bit up and or iffy or maybe if it's in all the repositories for all the distributions. You may have to either compile it yourself or add a PPA or go on to the AUR or, you know, stuff like that. If you're okay with that, go for it. And I've been using it for like 20 minutes and messing around with it. And so far, it seems to be working. And we all customize some buttons here. And it seems to be working just right. Again, I'm pressing the forward button. I'm pressing the backward button. Seems to be working. So if you're a gamer and you have a Logitech mouse or a gaming mouse or a mouse with more than one button, try this program out. Like I said, I think it works also with Razer mouse and stuff like that. It's not just a Logitech one. It's just if you look at the web page, they are highlighting a Logitech mouse. Again, test it out. I hope this was helpful. I hope this makes your gaming experience a little bit better. And I will see you all later. Bye-bye.